accidentally hit in the face. What was your first indication? Your nose broken or something on that play?
Yeah. I mean, I didn't know what it was. I didn't feel blood start trickling when it first happened, and then, you know, next thing I know, it's just Niagara Falls is flowing. So yeah, I was hoping that it wasn't a broken nose.
Well, how do you feel after you got hit, and is there a chance we're going to see masked PG?
No, it's not broken. My nose is not broken. I feel all right. It's sore. It's larger than usual right now. So hopefully just ice it down, help with the swelling. But nah, it won't be no mask for me.
Well, you and Kawhi connected on that dunk in the last minute of the game to put you guys up to. Can you describe what you saw in that play making the pass? And then also, you know, the two of you came to LA together, and this is maybe the first big clutch moment that the two of you paired up on. Did it feel like some kind of breakthrough, something was coming together there that hadn't before?
Well, in that play, Patty Mills gambled, and Kawhi was ahead of LaMarcus, and just saw an opportunity. After a great stop, we got out and pushed the break. Game is that close, you want an easy basket. So we was able to get an easy basket off that. And yeah, I mean, I think it's the more, again, time that we can get out there and be together as a group. I think you saw moments and flashes tonight of, you know, both of us being assertive offensively to score or make plays and playing off one another. And I think it's only going to get better from here.
Do you feel like you're starting to develop a rhythm offensively, kind of with the guys out on the floor? It seems like, you know, kind of in the second half, you got into a rhythm and a flow, and things started to open up a little bit more for you.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not shooting the ball as well as I want, but I'm getting the shots I want, and I think that's the best, and what all I can ask for at this point is just getting to a good flow of where my shots is going to come from. Now it's just, you know, repetition of knocking those shots down. So that's a good thing. But I think as a group, we're getting great quality looks. The more, again, we're out there, the more we play, the more all that time and stuff be cleaned up.
Paul, while you and Kawhi are kind of getting it going, how key is it to have a guy like Pat kind of be able to trust him with the ball and, a big shot and anything like that?
Yeah, it's great. It's great. I mean, it's been a couple times throughout this season where Pat has hit timely corner threes. You know, it's a huge luxury, especially when you got veteran guys and you know, just late game toughness guys, you know, that make big plays, whether it's a shot, it's a steal, it's a block, it's a charge. You know, you name it, we got a guy that's gonna step up and do it. So it's a huge luxury to have, and I think it just takes a lot of pressure off everyone.
Paul, do you feel like with the rhythm going, your game is coming together now as we head towards the All-Star break?
Yeah, I think so. I think so. Again, I'm getting great looks, getting the shots I want. I'm taking care of the ball for the most part, and trying to help with facilitating and be a playmaker. So I think I'm in a good place right now. Again, I want to make more shots. Obviously, everyone wants to make more shots, but just finding the ball through and just getting rhythm offensively as a scorer for us.
Well, what's the difference for you playing alongside Zoo and Trez in terms of the screening differential, the maybe rolling to the basket? What's the difference with those two?
Well, Zoo is a bigger body. And Zoo, you know, a lot of guys, we call it die on screens with Zoo because he's a big body and it's hard to get around him. So he frees up a lot of space, whereas Trez is a great roller. So that big, a lot of times, stays with Trez instead of trying to stop the ball because they know they got to keep their body on Trez. So it's both of them have a dynamic and a different, you know, thing that they bring when they're in that figure world.
Well, with the traded line coming up, I feel like a lot of guys talk about, you know, just kind of blocking out noise in the locker room as the deadline nears. Is that easier said than done when names are out there and speculation's out there for a locker room to kind of keep that stuff outside?
Well, I think fortunately for us, I haven't heard of anybody on the hot seat. So I think this locker room is good. We're in a good place. You know, and you know, we hope this is the roster going down the stretch that we keep. I enjoyed every player on this team. I enjoyed this locker room. And I'm happy with who's in our locker room.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.